Welcome to our today's class this particular morning, and I want us to actually do a question here that has actually been able to get extracted from a topic called calculus, and the subtopic is differentiation and its applications. So I'll first write down the question, then be able to go to the working so that you can get the answers to the question. So the question reads, the acceleration of a body, so the acceleration of a body, the acceleration of a body along a straight line is 4 minus t into meters per second squared. And its velocity v, and its velocity v meters per second after t as time is v. So you're told the body is accelerating. That means the body is moving with an increasing speed. And this body is moving along a straight line. So this must be linear motion. And its acceleration is 4 minus t meters per second squared. And the velocity, v meters per second of this body after a particular time t is given as v. Now, they are saying that Roman 1 or part A, the initial velocity is 3 meters per second. So the initial velocity of this body is 3 meters per second. In physics, we shall always refer to this as u. And of course, you have the initial velocity as u and the final velocity as v. So if the initial velocity of the body is 3 meters per second, you've been told express v in terms of t. So in other words, they want to want you to come up with an expression that can give us the velocity of this body at any particular given time. They want us to get the velocity of this body at any particular given time. Now what do? We want to move from acceleration at the question given to velocity. We always know this. From acceleration to velocity, we are supposed to actually integrate. So integrate the equation of acceleration for us to get the equation of velocity. How do we do this? We're going to have this. We're going to actually say 4 minus t can get integrated as, so we'll take 4. If there's no t, you introduce your t, then assume that t is raised to 0, then you say plus 1. So with integration, we always have to increase the power by 1 and divide everything by the sum of the resulting what? Power. So shall say divide this by 0 plus 1. Then you say less. Here we have t. So shall say t is already t. So there's actually 1 here. So shall say t raised to 1 plus 1. Then you divide the resulting power at the bottom. So we are going to say then plus a constant c that got eliminated from this, because at the moment we are actually having an equation that we got after differentiation had actually been done. So we are going back to the initial equation before we got this as our resultant equation after carrying out differentiation. So we are actually moving from an equation of acceleration to an equation of velocity. So from A to V, we integrate the equation of acceleration to get the equation of velocity. So we're going to have this 14 minus t squared over 2 plus a constant c. So this should be the most possible equation of our velocity. But again, we cannot be able to confirm what the constant was in the equation of this motion. We are going to have v as 3. So we can take the initial velocity to be 3. So we shall say 3 is equals to And if it was the initial velocity, then time must have actually been zero. The body starts the journey. The time is zero. And the body begins with a velocity of 3. So if the initial velocity is 3, you're going to say 3 is equal to 4 into, and time is 0, minus 0 squared divided by 2, then plus the constant. So 3 is equal to 0 minus 0 plus the constant c. So 3 is equal to the constant. So that our resultant equation for velocity is going to be v is equal to 4t minus t squared over 2 plus 3. That becomes the equation for the velocity of this particular body at any given time. Okay, so that is what you're supposed to have in as far as that working is concerned. And you're moving to something else. We want to actually end up getting now the answer to the question that actually follows this. So the answer to the second question, we are going to have the question first. They have said, find the velocity of the body after 2 seconds. So part B, we have velocity of the body after 2 seconds. The body began with a velocity of 3 meters per second. This is a question of getting the velocity of this body at any given time. So we obviously expect to find that after 2 seconds, the velocity of this body must be more than 3, because it began with a velocity of 3 when time was 0. So after 2 seconds, and because the body is accelerating, because of this equation, we expect the answer to be more than 3. So we're going to say v is equal to 4t minus t squared over 3, you can say over 2, as the denominator, plus 3 as our constant. So where there is t, we are going to replace with the 2. They want the velocity of this body after 2 seconds. So we shall say v is equal to 4 into 2, close the brackets, minus 2 as t squared over 2, then plus 3. So resultantly, we can actually be able to have 8 less, then this is 4 over 2 plus 3. So we can be able to have a simplified working where we are going to have this. We are going to have 8 less 2 plus 3. 8 less 2 plus 3. So 8 less 2 plus 3, the answer is equal to 8 less 2, that is 6. 6 plus 3. So you're going to have 9 meters per second. That is the velocity of the body after 2 seconds. So you can see the velocity of the body initially was 3 meters per second. And because the question tells us that the body is accelerating, we expect after 2 seconds the velocity to be more. So the body is actually moving with an increasing speed. It began with 3 meters per second. Then you've confirmed this, that after 2 seconds, the velocity of the body will be 9 meters per second. It has increased. So the body is accelerating. Now on to part C of the same question. The question is asking us to calculate the time taken to attain maximum velocity. So time, that is part C, time taken to attain maximum velocity. You see, when we have to put this question into consideration, we have just been actually able to get the question for velocity, and we've actually said the velocity of this body at a particular time t along the straight line, or as far as linear motion is concerned, is 4t minus t squared over 2 plus 3. That was the question we got in as far as velocity is concerned for this body. And we actually had to get the velocity of the body at 2 seconds and got the answer as 9 meters per second in our previous working. And we've actually gone ahead and we want to actually look at the time this body is going to take to attain maximum velocity. So the body had an equation of acceleration as 4 minus t. You see? And you see, when the question asks you to get the time taken for the body to attain maximum velocity, then that means at that point when the body attains maximum velocity, then the acceleration must be zero. I want to repeat this for clarity. I want to actually inform you that when the body attains maximum velocity, then the acceleration is zero. So we're going to take the equation of acceleration, which is 4 minus t, then equate this to zero. Because at maximum velocity, the acceleration is zero. So 4 minus t is equals to zero. So we shall actually be able to have 4 is equals to zero plus t. So that means the time taken for the body to attain maximum velocity is 4 seconds. The secret is, for the body to attain maximum velocity, the time taken can get obtained, whereby you're going to take the equation of acceleration, then equate to zero. Because at that maximum velocity, the acceleration of the body is zero. It cannot be able to further accelerate. It cannot be able to further increase in speed. That means at that point, it can't have any further acceleration. So the acceleration at that point is zero. But this says the distance covered by the body to attain maximum velocity. So distance covered to attain maximum velocity. Distance to attain maximum velocity. So distance to attain maximum velocity. So we have the equation of velocity as 4t minus t squared over 2 plus 3. But now, we are getting told to calculate the distance, and yet we do not have the equation for displacement. So displacement s can get obtained. So the equation for displacement can get obtained. How? From velocity to displacement s, you actually integrate. Just like the way I've told you, from acceleration to velocity, I also integrate. So in short, what I'm trying to say is this. From acceleration to velocity, integrate. So you have the equation of acceleration. You want to get the equation of velocity. Integrate the equation of acceleration. You have the equation of velocity. You want to get the equation of displacement or distance covered. What do? Integrate the equation of velocity for you to get the equation of displacement or distance covered by the body. So we shall come back here. We have 4t minus t squared over 2 plus 3. Then we shall say 4t raised to 1 plus 1. Integrating means you increase the power by 1, then divide the sum of the powers over everything. Now, then you say minus t squared, then you say plus 1. Look at that. Then you're going now to divide this by 3. Then plus 3, then you have now 3 times 2. Yes, 3 times 2, because you're going to say 2 plus 1 over 2 times 3. So you're going to have 2 powers. So you'll then say 3, a t is introduced, you raise this to 0, then you say plus 1. Then you say this is divided by 0 plus 1. So that I'm going to have 40 raised to 2 over 2 minus t cubed over 6 plus 3t. Yes, over 1. Correct. So we shall then end up having this. We have been told to get the distance covered to attain maximum velocity. We have to ask ourselves, when was time, or what was the time when the body attained its maximum velocity? The time was 4. So we shall just come here and further simplify and be able to get the answer. We shall have first this. We shall have 4 into 4 squared over 2 minus 4 cubed over 6 plus 3 into 4. 3 into 4. So you're going to have the displacement S as, so this is what you're supposed to use to get our answer when time is 4. So what do we do at the end of the day? You're going to have this. You're going to have 4 into 16, that is 4 squared over 2, minus 64, that is 4 raised to 3 over 6 plus 12. So let's just plug in these values. You're going to have, that is 2 there, 1 to there, 2. That will be 32 minus 64 over 6 plus 12. What is the answer in meters? Because you're getting the displacement of this body. Where is my calculator? So you're going to have this. You're going to have, let's see. You're going to have 32. Let me put on the calculator first. 32 less 64 over 6, then plus 12. So we are going to have 33.3. So you can actually write that as 33.3, then a dot to confirm that this value is recurring. Then you write meters because you need to get the distance. Very good. So that is our answer as far as the distance covered is concerned. So 33.3 recurring, or you can be able to as well say, or you can say 33 and a third meters. So the same thing.